I'll be joined by Simon Görtzen. We're going to talk Ascend, one of the new things you can do in Rivals of Ixalan. Specifically, we're going to look at a blue-black Ascend build. Just generally, Simon, what are you trying to do when you're trying to Ascend?
You're going to try to reach 10 permanents and then activate the City's Blessing or get the City's Blessing with one of your permanents or spells. And once you have it, you're not going to lose it again. All your creatures get bonuses. Your spells become better. Something like Golden Demise, for example, will never kill your own creatures anymore. I think it's one of the top uncommons in the set,
by the way. It's amazing. It feels like a rare.
Yeah, and you can, if you draft it early, you can also build your deck around it. And we see players at this tournament actually prioritize treasure making and token making very heavily because Ascending is just so much easier.
Well, what we're going to actually do is go through a draft of an Ascend deck. Not exactly the ideal Ascend deck, but something you might end up with if you're just drafting on Magic Online or something like that.
Exactly, and this is an example of a blue-black Ascend deck that actually splashes two colors. So it's a bit more greedy, but that's what you can do with Treasures and something like Traveler's Amulet.
Yeah, starting out here with Traveler's Amulet, it's not always a card that you think might go in an Ascend deck, but as you said, if you're using those treasures to splash, might as well.
Absolutely.
All right, let's move on to the next photo here. We're going to look at our two drops, Moment of Craving, Gleaming Barrier, Dusk Legion Zealot, and Dinosaur Hunter. Gleaming Barrier is what's kind of standing out to me here.
Yeah, it doesn't block all the two drops in the format, but it blocks everything that has three power or less. It also generates a treasure, so it's just really good in these multicolor Ascend decks. You can tell from the two drops that this is not an aggressive deck. This is a very controlling deck. You're using Dinosaur Hunter as a pseudo Death Toucher. You're using Dust Legion Zealot to draw deeper into your deck. And Moment of Craving is, the discussion is still ongoing. Is this maybe even better than Impale?
All right, let's take a look at our three drop slot, and here is where the meat of the deck lives, Simon. Number one card I want to point out, of course, Sailor of Means.
Yeah, I don't know if you need four of them.
This is the dream here.
But if you do, then you can suddenly play red, white, black, white, blue, four colors without any problem.
And there's Golden Demise that you mentioned, one of the payoffs for hitting Ascend. Also a card like Secrets of the Golden City. How good is this once you Ascend?
Well, drawing three cards is amazing for a single card. The great thing is Secrets of the Golden City is also fine without having Ascended. Golden Demise in such a deck can be great without Ascend. So you really want to look for the cards that either are amazing when Ascended or that are also good when not. So you don't want the high variance.
And Profane Procession, just pointing out here, is a kind of an example of a bomb that we're looking to splash if we happen to end up with, like this person did, four Sailor of Means. This, of course, a harder card to splash. We've got our Traveler's Amulet, though, to help us find our planes.
Exactly. You can see here that it's seven islands, seven swamps, a plains, and a mountain. And with Traveler's Amulet, you have those 17 mana sources that you want. Get a plains, play Profane Procession, and then you just activate, flip, and win the game, hopefully.
Let's look at our four drop slot to see some of more of our Ascend payoffs. We've got one here in Deadeye Brawler, which whenever Deadeye Brawler deals combat damage to player, if you have the City's Blessing, you get to draw a card. Also Spirewinder.
Yeah, Deadeye Brawler is a tremendous card. If you look at the card without Ascend, it's already a 2/4 death touch that threatens to kill anything it blocks or attacks into, and it has four toughness. But then, after you've Ascended, it becomes so, it becomes so tough not to block it. It's a really good card.
And Spirewinder, of course, growing larger with Ascend. Something I just want to point out here, Twilight Prophet, an amazing Vampires card. Ravenous Chupacabra, just obviously you want one in any deck that's black. Dust Charger, Dire Fleet Interloper. We've got different, we have pirates, we have vampires. Do we care about creature types in Ascend?
No. It really doesn't matter, and this is why blue-black, but also blue-black is, of course, a pirate tribe color combination, but blue-white doesn't have a tribe associated with it, which makes it perfect to draft Ascend. Twilight Prophet, by the way, is just absurdly good.
Oh, yes. All right, let's take a look here at our five-drop slot, Prosperous Pirates and Contract Killing, some other ways that we're splashing for some of our cards in this deck.
Three permanents, two permanents on a spell, that's great for Ascending.
All right, and finally, we've got, oh, that's Azahal, Primal Tide. Sure, get in the deck, buddy. 7/7 for 7. Is this like an ascend path? Is that what we're doing with our treasure? If we're
it's what we're doing with the treasure. So because the city's blessing doesn't go away, you're gonna have those 3-4 treasures lying around. And if you haven't used them to cast your off-color spells, then you definitely want something to sink your mana into. Now, Nezahal is traditionally not a first pickable card in this format, but you can get it, and then if you cast it on turn 5, well, that's amazing.
Overall, Simon, how do you like the Ascend deck in general?
I think it's great that it exists because blue-white was lacking a clear focus. You could draft blue-white flyers, but it wasn't really something that you were excited about. Now, when I look at Ascend, I know that there are so many payoff cards, and actually Spirewinder is one of the weaker ones. You want the cards that just grow out of control when you have reached the magical number 10.
I'm excited to draft a Sailor Moon's Ascend deck. Simon Görtzen, thanks so much. Blue-black Ascend. More magic after this.